On May 20th, the formal swearing-in ceremony of the new president of Ukraine, Volodymyr Zelensky, was held in the main legislative chamber of the Supreme Council of Ukraine in Kyiv. 1 month earlier, in the second round of Ukraine's presidential elections, the 41-year-old Zelensky scored a landslide victory over incumbent presidential candidate Petro Poroshenko, gaining roughly 73% of the vote. Zelensky's inaugural speech emphasized Ukrainian commonality, togetherness and inclusivity, and joint responsibility. And he stated that his first task is a ceasefire in the Donbas. In Zelensky's words, припинення вогню на Донбасі.
Наше найперше завдання – припинення вогню на Донбасі. Задля того, щоб наші герої більше не гинули, я готовий на все. І я точно не боюсь приймати складні рішення. Я готовий втрачати свою популярність, свої рейтинги. І якщо буде треба, я без вагань готовий втратити свою посаду, щоб тільки настав мир. Не втрачаючи наші території. Не ми почали цю війну, але нам цю війну закінчувати.
Zelensky went on to say that his next challenge is the recovery of Ukraine's occupied territories. In his words, lost territories. Повернення втрачених територій. He did not specify how he plans to achieve this task. President Zelensky sharply criticized the Ukrainian government, quoting the slogan, "The government is, in fact, our problem." That is, Уряд не вирішує проблем, він і є наші проблеми. Also, in a controversial move, Zelensky dissolved the Supreme Council of Ukraine, thus setting the stage for the early parliamentary elections to take place in July. Current polls suggest that Zelensky's still largely unformed party, Sluha Narodu, Servant of the People, is expected to win the largest number of seats in the new parliament. Several hours after the swearing-in ceremony, Prime Minister of Ukraine Volodymyr Groysman announced his resignation from his post. He indicated that his decision was made in direct response to President Zelensky's criticism of the government.
Я вважаю, що він сьогодні своєю заявою взяв на себе всю відповідальність перед тими загрозами майбутньому, які є на порядку денному.
Groysman also announced that he will run for office in the upcoming parliamentary elections. I'm Tanya Stech, and this was Ukraine in the News.
Канал 1+1 тепер доступний на Bell International Programming.